So here we have a 1972 Tanzer. It's actually a Canadian brand boat that I bought from my boss. Looks a lot better the further you stand away from it. It was in pretty rough shape. Hasn't been painted anytime recently. The underside's pretty gross. It is a freshwater boat, but still a lot of the caulking on the side here is dried up. You can see it's peeling away in some spots. There's chunks of it missing. All of the teak wood hasn't been treated with oil or any kind of varnish. It's all dried up. I don't know if I'll be able to save those or not, or if I'll be able to refinish them. I'll probably have to buy new teak and trace them. The windows are pretty dirty. That's a window there. You can see through the other side a little bit. There's a crack right here. All the trim here, I don't know if this is caulking or some kind of rubber seal, but it's probably just old as the boat, so it's all dried up. The windows leak a little bit. No idea on the lighting. I never really tried it. I have a battery for it over there that came with the boat, but it's been sitting for a few years, so I doubt that's any good. The rest of the boat's pretty much the same way. There's some hooks here for some old ladder system that came with the boat. It's no longer there, so I'm going to remove these. You can see there's random holes where old stuff was mounted. It's been removed. The holes were never filled. This is for the outboard motor. It's in pretty rough shape. It's for the tiller. It's where the VIN number is for a boat. I think it's called something else, not a VIN, but the other side is kind of the same way. You can see all the paint's all scuffed up, scratched, chipped. The boat used to be a light blue. You can kind of see it here where the paint's chipped away. It doesn't appear very, very well. This is in my garage. We're able to back the trailer in here as a tight fit. Use some straps on my lift to lift it up about a foot. And then drove the trailer out from under it. And I set it down on some 2x12s right there. This is some styrofoam in a cardboard box that I conveniently had. Just got a transmission shipped back to me, so I cut the bottom of it, wedged it in there. It's pretty stable. It'll rock a little, but you can walk around on it and go all the way to the edges. Here's the top of the boat. It's really dirty. It's going to need a good cleaning. I don't know if I'll paint it or re-gel coat it or what, but you can see some of the gel coat is cracked, there's chips missing, the hinges need to be cleaned up, you got regular screws there, Phillips head there, the latches, there's a lot of dirt in the crevices. Same with the other one. Here's probably the worst spot on top of the boat. Now this is going to be tricky because you can see this is a non-skid surface. It's got cracks in this fiberglass or gel coat that goes over there, so I'm going to have to dig all that out. I'm not 100% sure what I'll do with a non-skid surface. I know I can fix it, but it may not have the matching pattern. Maybe I'll be able to steal the pattern, making some kind of mold of a section that's good, or see what they do online for that. Here's the opening to the sailboat. Slides back. This is teak wood, too, in kind of rough shape. You can see there's a chunk of it broken off there. Cover's closed. There's still enough to kind of hold it. I don't know if I'll replace those board sections or not. I'm going to see what teak runs, how easy it is to get. Now I may try to make them look kind of symmetrical, providing I can actually restore this wood. It's not all dry rotted. Some more cracking right here. This is a compass that the guy mounted. It's a little bit hard to see, but it's actually crooked. It wasn't mounted flush if the boat was level, so I may fix that. We'll see. Here's some more holes from something else that used to be there. Let's go inside the boat. That's the... It's actually the floor right here. You can see. It's got like a crack right along here. So it's not as structurally sound as this side. I don't see any good way to fix it, but I may be able to prop something under it just so it won't squeak, at least. It's nothing too structural in the boat. It's just annoying getting in and out. And that's probably how it broke. Somebody jumped down in here, landed on this side first, 200 pounds to this from 2 feet, probably did it. Here's the table. It's not very sturdy. It folds down and it goes there. You can make this a longer bed. The wood on the inside is not too bad because it's been protected, but all the white walls really needs bleach. It kind of smells a little bit in here. Insides of the window, so you can see the foam padding trim is coming out. Here's the, if you can see this. Here's the little sink spout, so corroded. There's supposedly a water jug behind there, but I don't think I would drink anything out of it. Maybe if I rinse it in bleach for a few days. Here's the ice box. The seal all around it's broken. I don't know what I'll do about that. It's got a little John. I'll probably take that out of here. Here's the sleeping area. Here's one of the foam things. It's got a nice rip in it. Maybe I can find someone who can sew. Here's the hatch at the top. It's got some solar fan here, but it never seemed to work. The guy cut that open, so maybe I can find some kind of watertight replacement or another fan. There's a little reading light and a little shelf. A bunch of wires over there. It's kind of a hack job if you ever... I don't think you can see that. Big spider web of wiring down there. That's the main switch panel. Some of the rocker switches don't work. There's the CB radio. Of course, without the battery, I can't really call for help. Hopefully, I'll never come to that. Take a look up here. This is actually for the centerboard. It's got a folding centerboard. That's kind of what I liked about the boat, because you can go in shallow water if you pull it up. Makes it easy for getting it out of the water. You don't have to pay a crane $100 a year to pull it out, $100 to put it in. You can just do it yourself. The mast isn't too bad to put up, but you won't want to be doing it every time you take the boat for a cruise, so I have more. There's some more cracking on the top here. That's probably the thing I'm most concerned about, is fixing that to look halfway decent. This is where the anchor goes underneath here. It's got these two little, there's one remaining piece of wood to kind of hold it down. This piece is missing. I'll have the fabric something there. These are for poles for a little railing up here. I had to take it off to fit it in the ground. The railing's down there. That's in pretty good shape, actually. So I will be keeping that on the boat. Some of them have a railing that go halfway around the sides, but this one doesn't. Here's an antenna connector. It can go up the mast for the CB radio. I got to make sure that works and has continuity through it. But yeah, that's my boat. This is a before video. Hopefully the after video will come sooner than later. So there you go. So here's a look at my 1972 Tanzer 40-year-old boat that I finished restoring pretty much this morning, finishing the last touches. It took about probably 2 months to do the boat and the trailer. It was in pretty rough shape. I redid the bottom paint. It's a West Marine blue paint to keep barnacles from building up. It's a special design. It's meant for boats that spend the summer in the water and the winter undercover, so we get a lot of snow here in Vermont. The side of the boat is a white gloss marine paint. Got the exact name of it. Same with the blue, it's the same kind of paint that I did the stripe along the top of it. The rub rails painted with the same white paint. Same with the top of the boat. I used a special primer by Interlux. It's a epoxy primer that's actually meant to fill some of the creasing from the gel coat. But I sanded down the gel coat pretty good before even applying the primer. New window seals and Lexan for it. I got the Lexan from Lowe's, a special UV stuff. The actual seals here are from Tanzer. I was able to get it up in Canada. I reused the frames. I was just really careful removing them. The window's a little dirty. There's some dust on the inside. But the seal stuff is about $4 a foot, and there's some foam that goes behind it, so around $100 worth of seals. All the deck hardware was taken off. All the teak wood was sanded down and refinished. Rather than oiling it, I actually used a deck stain and then a special clear polyurethane over it. There's the tiller. You can see the light up there. I had to rewire all of the lights, make sure that they all work. Here's the trailer. The trailer actually took a lot of TLC too. It's got new wheels on it. I had to do one wheel bearing. I put the bearing buddies on it. I painted the drums, greased everything good. The axles were pretty rusty. You can see it. But they're a lot better now. The rest of the trailer is galvanized, so I didn't want to paint it. But I used an actual silver seal roofing paint on the axles, and it was night and day. I used the same stuff on these little fenders. They're nothing special, but I didn't want to spend $200-$300 on new fenders, so I straightened them out the best I could with a hammer and took a brush to them. Did new carpet on the running boards too. It's also got all new brake lines and wiring, new brake assembly on this front one. It's the e-brake, or the brake shoe is a little worn. I need to get a new front braking system. I'm going to do this later. I just want to get the boat in the water. This thing right here is all frozen up on the inside. And I'm going to redo this mechanism. It's not very well designed, because when you pull the boat up on the trailer, this cable, it wants to rub on this pad. So I'm going to get new pads and maybe melt that higher a little bit differently. Let's take a look at the top now. There is a rail thing on the top. It just wouldn't fit with that pole there. I think I put the boat on the trailer a little bit too far when I dropped it back down off the lift. I'm waiting on a new pad here from West Marine too. It had some plywood, but it was all rotten. So I'm getting some poly board. The ladder over here. Yeah, the poly board won't rot. I'll go up a little higher than I need to kick off my shoes. So here's the top. It's kind of sunny out. But I had to redo the lockers. The wood inside them was rotten, so I cut them open, replaced the wood, fiberglassed them shut. All of, step in here. I don't know if you can see this because of the sun is really bright. But all of the anti-skid surface that comes from the factory, it's got like a proprietary pattern to it, and it's hard to replace. So I sanded it all down and used my own anti-skid. It's a special roller. It's by Kiwi Grip. Washes off in water. Really, really good stuff. There's the gas tank. New foam seal. Here's the entrance. I remounted the compass. There are some extra holes there that I filled in from previous stuff that was mounted there. No idea what it was. Same with that guy down there. There are two other holes with some electrical connectors I removed from some old hardware. It's the tiller. So let's open this bad boy up. I'll probably do another video when it's on the water. I don't know how well this is coming out with the glare, but I put some carpet down, some outdoor carpet. These are all the same cushions. They're not in horrible shape. They cleaned up fairly well, but I'm gonna eventually do them probably next year. I just want to get the boat in the water this year. All the interior wood, even the bulkheads, everything was removed, sanded down, used the same stuff I used outside, a deck stain and then a polyurethane over it. It's a little bit hot in here. I made the curtains last night. I didn't use the same mounting system, but it's pretty sufficient. These are just electrical wire connectors. I think they're 1/4-inch stainless screw, little wood dowel, and made the curtains to slide them open. So that came out a lot better than I expected. There's a fridge. The fridge and the table are kind of in rough shape. The wood on it's not actually wood, it's like a vinyl panel, luan, whatever you call it. I actually took them out, but I never replaced them. I may try to do that next year as kind of a mini project. I got a little DC fan, because it can get hot in here. I made the carpet go all the way up here. There's the front of it, that little drain thing's for the little cubby on top where the anchor sits, so if water gets in there, it'll drain through that pipe. Let me take this guy off. So I did a new electrical panel too. This one's got two cigarette lighters, which I like because it'll control the little DC fan. The old one was fuses too. The new one's actually got breakers, so if something goes, it just kicks a breaker. All the lights work. It's got a little CB radio up there. Here's a submarine battery, but it's not a deep cycle. I may get one eventually, but I rewired everything. May not look pretty, but it's a lot better than it was. Everything's soldered. I put a grounding block in there just to make it a little bit neater. There's a bunch of old wire in too that I was able to rip out of here from old stuff. I haven't touched that yet, but I probably will. You can actually hook an electrical cord to the outside of the boat. And it'll go through that little breaker box, and there's a outlet there. Next year I want to do something with the sink too. There's a 5-gallon storage thing in the back of the fridge underneath there, but you can't really remove it. It's all fiberglassed in. This is where you fill it right here. It's a 40-year-old boat, so I don't know what's down there. I could bleach it really well, but I probably wouldn't trust myself drinking from it. So what I want to do is cut it open right here, right on the side here. I'm going to cut a square thing, make a nice fancy wood cover, and cut right into that water box, hopefully, and use it kind of as a shelf so I can put my own water jug in there, put the wood over it. I'll have a line going to it that comes up to
this pump, and I'll probably replace this pump. It'll be a little electric pump, and then I'll have a running sink, and I'll trust drinking from it. Yeah, that's more or less it. I'll show you the top of it. I'm gonna replace that solar cap thing someday. It's supposed to run a little fan, but it's all burnt out. The top's all kiwi gripped. Just where the factory stuff, the skid surface was, everything else the same paint. Here's the wood I refinished. You can see right here, like, it was cracked, but I epoxied it back in. I could have bought new teak, but kind of on a budget, and that worked really well, actually. Still a little dusty, but it'll wash off. And that's it. Hopefully I'll have it in the water later today, or possibly tomorrow afternoon.